For our video for Needing Getting, we wanted to make all the sounds live. That was sort of the challenge, right? Tim, do you recall what instruments you played?
Yeah, I mean, basically I played the car.
You played the car. We're not playing our rock and roll instruments, we're using the car to generate all those sounds. And that pretty much meant figuring out how to transfer speed into music. We just hit a lot of stuff mostly, right? Mm-hmm. But by the end of the video, the sound you're hearing, it essentially, you can basically hear the science we did to get there. We had to figure out how those instruments worked. We had to figure out our velocity at every place on the track. We had to figure out distances between everything, the force with which we are traveling. Here's what I'm thinking. This machine, the phone in my pocket, is actually an incredible science instrument. It's got every kind of sensor I can think of. Well, you're the nerd. Tell me what instruments are in this.
You got a light sensor in there. It measures the light hitting the lens. You have a gyroscope, which is the position of the phone. Accelerometer, which is the speed that the phone is moving. There's a compass, so which direction it's facing. You have a barometer.
Barometer.
So air pressure.
Yeah, so you know if it's gonna rain?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Wow. Basically, it always felt like this thing was just had some crazy brain, but it's actually a whole bunch of sensors, and Google has made this app called Science Journal where we can access each one of them. So we'll see the science going in there. Now here's the musical part. You can actually set it so that you hear the value, right? Mm. So that if you've got like a low value because there's low light, there'll be a low note. Mm-hmm. And if you take off your hand and it gets a lot of light, then all of a sudden you get a high note. So you can actually play this science instrument like a musical instrument, which is essentially exactly what we did in our video.
Hmm. Cool. So you can see you'll see that it's low and you'll hear it low, and then you can see that it's high and you'll hear a higher note.
Yeah, well, let's just play with it and I think it'll become clear.
Cool. All right, so what sensor are you gonna use right now?
I'm using the ambient light one.
Cool, let's hear it.
Okay, it's set to a scale.
Mm.
It's really meditative and kind of sweet.
You wanna get zen?
Yeah, this is a zen moment.
So I'm on compass.
Okay.
So for me, it's gonna change which direction I'm facing.
Getting more relaxed as we do this.
I'm in a deeply meditative state.
Science, light and sound. Science, light and sound. Science, light and sound. Is science, light and sound.
Wait, which is yours doing right now? You're doing compass.
No, it's drum solo.
Oh, sorry.
Oh yeah, ladies and gentlemen, Demi Kulash. All right.
So I've got mine set to magnetometer.
Okay.
And it's got a setting where there's it'll shut off if there's no input. So so if I introduce this magnet into the scene, it reacts. Check it out.
Cool.
So if I do something with rhythm, you could probably get in.
Yeah.
It's pretty musical.